How was it? Bad as ever?
Worse.
How do you feel? Better? You look it. Did you sleep?
A little.
But you do feel better.
Oh, how better can I feel? Yes, it's daylight. That helps. And the house is quiet. It's empty.
You didn't... That is... Sorry if I ask.
Ask.
Well, I've been thinking that these voices you've been hearing is some sort of nightmare. We all have them.
Do we? That's so generous of you. You live in such a simple world, Robert.
Look, I'm not even awake yet.
I don't know if I envy you or pity you. Tell me, does the rose on your mother's grave smell as sweet as the rose on your wedding day?
You do feel better.
Well, if I do, it's because I told you. They're gone.
You mean they're out there? In the blizzard?
I don't know where they are. It's not a matter of time or location. I heard them talking this morning. There was some fuss about boats or raincoats. It was raining where they were. The little boy.
Go on.
The little boy lost his rubbers. They could only find one rubber.
Did you happen to hear where they were going?
Yes, they were going to church and then to a cemetery. The children had fresh flowers to put on their daddy's grave.
The dead bury the dead. Go on.
No, but there was so much laughing.
No tears, no sadness, no one dragging a chain or their head in their hands.
Don't tease me, Robert. You know, it could be true. Maybe I'm a medium.
Oh, you are good at Ouija boards, you and your mother, and that other crazy thing up at Harry's farm.
The divining rod. I did find water. The fork. It twisted in my hands.
And now you're projecting voices. Tell me, AM or FM?
Don't.
Light of my life, never lose your sense of humor. Laughter always saved us, and maybe it'll save us now.
Save us? Laughter is a disease. Didn't I ever tell you about the woman at the hospital? Her disease was laughter. She lost 32 pounds laughing. She found everything funny. Chairs, the doors, the bars on the windows. I would see her on the ground in the morning laughing at stones, flowers, trees.
Well, that is funny. So often in humor, there's an irrational factor, and sometimes that's what makes it funny, because insanity is irrational. But what are we supposed to do? Stop laughing? What happened to her, your laughing woman?
Well, they couldn't stop her. She became skin and bones. The cheeks hollow, the eyes. She was a skeleton sitting in a wheelchair. But the shoulders still hunched over, shaking, with silent laughter. Stones, flowers, leaves blowing along the walk.
You feel warm.
Do I? My throat's scratchy. Bob, if I were a medium, I've gone to seances. Usually it's just frowsy, women riding, mumbling in the dark, but this one time I saw ectoplasm. It could have been fake, but it seemed to flow from the woman's body as this substance, you know, that the soul uses when it materializes. Another time, just after Jamie's death.
No, Claire!
This medium, she spoke to me in Jamie's voice. Jamie's voice, Robert. Do you think I don't know my son? Do you think I can't tell his voice from 10,000 others? I heard the sea, the way it was that day, you know, when the waves crash against the rock like it does when the tide is high. This medium told me that after a sudden death, such as an accident or a suicide, the soul sustained the shock. It can't make the transition. And if that's true, maybe that's why Jamie...
Enough! I don't want to hear any more of this.
Okay, I won't talk about it. I'll just say his name over and over. Jamie, Jamie, Jamie. Sometimes I think that word is the sweetest in all the world.
No sweeter than Bill or George or John.
John?
John?
You're no different than any other woman who lost her son with dignity. With grief, sure, God, with grief.
Suicide is undignified. I'm me. No, not all the other brave women in the world. We all have a different capacity for pain. There are different degrees of sensitivity to suffering, just as there are to love.
Your endowment, I take it, was great?
I was able to learn that much at the hospital.
But not how to heal yourself? Even when Jamie was alive, there was something tragic between the two of you. It wasn't just a conspiracy, it was full-blown mystique.
With a five-year-old boy?
Sometimes, my darling, you're more Victorian than this house. What we're talking about is the worst, most possessive kind of love. What are you doing?
Doing what, listening?
Not to me, to what?
To what? To the house? At what? Them! They're here! They're in the house!
Claire, there's nothing in this house. This house is empty. You're imagining something you can't have. A child, a family. Claire, sweetheart, again and again, the answer is always the same one word. Jamie, accept his death.
No! Jamie isn't dead! Not really. Nothing dies, Robert. A flower that blooms once blooms forever. In this world, we must take off our lives, second by second, event by separate event. We're like people on a train. only able to see a segment of time's landscape as we pass. We're only able to travel from past to future. But in death, we can experience time as it is, whole. We can travel from past to future, future to past, recreating, reliving every event of our lives.
I see. Anything to keep Jamie in some netherworld where someday he'll join him. Claire, this house is empty.
No, you don't understand. It's here. The other night, when you went upstairs, I saw a light, but I didn't tell you. Oh, how could I tell you? You look at me with those clear eyes, and I feel ashamed, like I'm making up some monstrous lie just to ashamed you. Because you are to blame, Robert, what happened to Jamie, not me.
But he fell. He slipped. It wasn't your fault or mine. We went to the beach all the time. There was no danger, but he climbed where he was told not to climb. Now will you understand that and accept it and stop killing yourself and me?
Well, I guess I have my answer, right, Dr. Williams?
To what?
Well, if I'm not a medium, then I guess I'm crazy.
I think you're just exhausted, upset.
Stop the euphemisms. I'm insane. Matt, they're gonna come back and you're gonna hear them and see them just like I do. And you can't stop them, and I can't either.
Do you want some snow?
We're gonna poison ourselves drinking that broken snow.
There's some wine, it's not bad.
From a broken bottle.
And strained it last night.
Through what?
A pair of wool socks.
You didn't.
They were clean, weren't they? They came from your suitcase.
Oh. I mean, I don't know whether to laugh or cry. Everything inside of me seems dislocated and stressed. Robert, my hands are dirty. I'm going to clean with the snow water. I think there's a mirror upstairs. Can you go get it?
I suppose I can try. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the most fairest of them all? 'Tis you, my fair queen of that I'm sure, filled with glamour and allure. You are by far the prettiest of the land, even though you've dirtied hand. You are by far the best and most rare, my lovely, lovely Lady Claire.
How can you be so silly? Mother, look, a green moon. It's yellow. He still doesn't know his color.
Oh, stop it, both of you. You've done nothing but argue all day. I'm tired of it. John, show me what you've drawn. I think you're going to be an artist.
Claire.
I'm going to be a singer.
Singer?
I learned a new song the other day.
Did you sing it, darling?
I'm saving it for John's birthday.
John's birthday.
Stop it.
I cannot wait for tomorrow. It's much too long.
Tomorrow? Did you hear?
There's nothing to hear.
So clear. So plain. I just can't stand it.
Stop, damn it. Now sit there and behave like a woman. Voices, songs, apparitions. What's next? Another razor? This house is empty. Empty. Empty!